sandstorm is underway for the first 15 seconds of the match. Total blackout conditions on planet Primus. As we move forward, the bots are showing the human players what's happening on the planet surface with their cameras that are located on their robots. And now the bots are being controlled with a full field of vision of the planet surface. As the bots, 36, 35, the Flying Legion flies over to the third bay of the cargo ship, scoring 3 points for the Red Alliance by placing that cargo pod in the cargo bay. As their alliance partner also did on the opposite side, that was 75-14, Eve Robotics. Now 40-26 and 41-12, dancing together. Now 49-41 joins in the mix, but they move to the front of the cargo ship with that cargo pod to score 3 points. If they can place it in the cargo bay successfully, which they did, their RoboBiv team did. Global Dynamics playing defense against the Blue Alliance bots, against 41-12, the Eagle bots. As 49-41 makes it to the side of the cargo ship, scoring another 3 points for the Blue Alliance. It's 44-28 with T-minus 85 seconds left to go in the match as action continues on the planet surface. 75-14, Eve Robotics at the loading zone beside 36-35, who picks up a hatch panel. They take the hatch panel, spin around, and head towards the Red Alliance rocket to place that hatch panel, to close it so that they can secure their cargo in the rocket. It falls back to the planet surface. When they score a hatch panel, those round discs that you see out there on the field that they're working with, if they can place them on the hatch panels, onto the hatches of the cargo ship or the rockets, they gain 2 points. As we're down to T-minus 49 seconds to go until launch, it's 50-34 in favor of the Red Alliance right now. 49-41 for the Blue Alliance has a hatch panel in their possession. With the open hatch, they back away. That's 40-26 Global Dynamics was playing some good defense. They move to the other end of the field and place that hatch panel on the other rocket for the Blue Alliance, gaining 2 points for that alliance. As we're T-minus 24 and counting, it's 52-38 in favor of the Red Alliance. We're now in the end game as 41-12. The Eagle Bots score high and the Blue Alliance rocket. 40-26 Global Dynamics flips over onto the third level of the half platform. That's worth 12 at 75-14. Lexi climbs up onto the second level worth 6 points, and 36-35 follows, scoring 3 points for the Red Alliance. That's the end of match number one of what will be 90 total qualifying matches over the course of the next 2 days. They're checking the cargo to make sure it's secure, checking all the passengers to make sure they're secure in the half platform zone. We're waiting for a word from First Command to tell us it's good to go. And then we'll watch from afar the screen. At NASA, they keep you 3 miles away. We're keeping you just a little bit closer, but you can still see the launch. When we get the word go, and we have the word go, let's watch the screen for match number one. We have okay. We're continuing to be in a holding pattern. I hear the sound. I see no video launch. I guess the cameras are out right now. Here we go, we have the launch. 73-49 in favor of the Red Alliance. And we have a new score for the event. New high score for the event.
Oh, yeah.
All right, before we get started with match number two, let's watch the screen for our game animation. Tell us a little bit about the game.
Welcome to the 2019 First Row Robotics Competition and this year's game, Destination Deep Space, presented by the Boeing Company. Two alliances of deep space travelers race to place hatch panels on their rockets and cargo ship, load valuable cargo for transport off the planet, and return to the safety of their habitat, all before the next sandstorm sweeps through. Each alliance has two rockets, one cargo ship, and a habitat. Hatch panels and cargo are available through the human player stations, and cargo is also available in the depots adjacent to the habitats. Robots start in their habitat and may be preloaded with one game piece. Alliances may also choose to preload some bays of their cargo ship with either hatch panels or cargo. During the first 15 seconds of each match, driver vision of the field will be blocked by a waning sandstorm. So robots must be controlled using either autonomous code or manually with a vision system on the robot. Alliances earn points for exiting the habitat, securing hatch panels, and any cargo that's properly stored. Cargo not secured spills from the cargo ship. As the sandstorm ends, driver vision returns, and alliances continue to earn points by loading their spacecraft. Alliances earn a rank point during qualifying matches for completing one rocket with hatch panels and cargo. Near the end of the match, robots return to the safety of their habitat for the upcoming launch and to earn more points. The alliance that earns the most points wins the match.
Going into match number two, let's start off with the Red Alliance and Team 4.